हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू अवर चैनल ब्रेन अलाइव। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस द इनपुट एंड आउटपुट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ कॉमन एमिटर ट्रांजिस्टर कॉन्फ़िगरेशन। हेयर इनपुट टर्मिनल इज कैप्ट कॉमन बिटवीन इनपुट एंड आउटपुट साइड। बेस एंड एमिटर जंक्शन आर फॉरवर्ड बायस बाय दिस बैटरी VBB। सो दिस वोल्टेज VBE इज द वोल्टेज बिटवीन बेस एंड एमिटर जंक्शन एंड दिस IB इज द करंट एट इनपुट साइड। This VC is the voltage between collector and emitter and IC is the output current. Input characteristics are drawn between input voltage and input current at the fixed value of output current. Now to draw input characteristics, we will fix the value of IC, output current, and change the value of VB in steps and record the corresponding change in IB. Now, we will get this curve. Now we will fix some other value of IC and change the value of VB in steps and record the corresponding value of IB. So we will get these curve by doing this process. Now we will analyze the input characteristics of common emitter. Here, this is the voltage between base and emitter. It is in volts. And the current IB is in microampere. This is in microampere because base current is very small as base region is very thin and lightly doped. We can see here the shape of these curves is very similar to forward wired diode. This is because base and emitter junction here are forward biased and they act like a PN junction diode. The second thing that we observe in this graph is when we increase base emitter voltage, the current rises rapidly. But this rapidness is less in CE configuration as compared to CB configuration. That's why the input resistance of common emitter configuration is higher than common base configuration. Now, other thing that we are observing in this curve, as we increase the VCE voltage, the fixed voltage VCE, these curves shift towards the right. Also, we can see here when we have fixed the value of VC equals to 1 volt, the current is 60 microampere and the voltage VB is 0.7 volt here. And when we increase this VCE up to 10 volt, the current is also 60 microampere, but the value of VB is greater, that is around 1.1 volts. So we can see here the current IB reduces when we increase this voltage VCE fixed value with VBE. The reason behind shifting of these curves towards right and decreasing of this base current with increasing the fixed value of VCE is when we increase this voltage VCE, this increases the reverse biasing at collector junction. And increasing of reverse biasing increases the depletion width of depletion region at this junction. And because this base region is lightly doped, so the penetration of depletion region goes more into the base region. Due to this, the actual width of the base region reduces, and so less number of electron or and holes combine here, and more number of electrons goes into the collector region. That's why this current, IB current, reduces and the curve shifts towards the right. Now we can find the AC input resistance of common emitter configuration. This is given by change in voltage between base and emitter upon change in base current at the constant value of VCE, means output voltage. This can be found out by taking two points any of these two curves. We are taking two points on this curve. Now we will draw perpendicular from these two points on x-axis and on y-axis. Now we will find the difference between these two voltages and then these two currents and find out the input resistance. In case of common emitter, this input resistance is very low, but it is slightly higher than of common base configuration. Now we will discuss the output characteristics of common emitter configuration. It is drawn between output voltage and output current at a fixed value of base current. Here, output voltage is VC, output current is IC, it is measured in milliampere, and the input current is IB, it is measured in microampere. To draw output characteristics, first we will fix some value of IB and change the value of VCE in steps and record the value of current IC. Now we'll repeat this process for some other values of IB. And using this data, we will draw the output characteristics here. Now we will analyze the output characteristics. Here we can see different regions. The region towards the left of this line is saturation region, and the region that containing these curves is active region, and the region under this curve IB, when IB is equals to 0, is cutoff region. Now we will explain these three regions one by one. First we will consider active region. In active region, base emitter junction is forward bias and collector base junction is reversed bias. We can see here, when we increase the fixed value of IB, first is 0 microampere, then 10, 20, 30 and 40 microampere. We can see through these curves that when we increase the fixed value of IB, these curves are moving slightly upward. We can observe the difference between this curve and this curve. It is slightly upward than this curve. This is more parallel to this x-axis. This shows that at lower values of IB, there is very less increase in IB when we increase the value of VCE. So, impact of increasing VCE is not appreciable in IC at lower values of IB, means it does not increase with VC at lower values of IB. But when we increase the value of IB, take an example, let it 40 microampere, there is a increment of IC when we increase the value of VCE. So it shows that at lower values of IB, there is no increase in IC with VCE, but at higher values of IB, there is an increment of IC with VCE. This is because when we increase the value of VCE, VCE is equals to VCB, means collector to base voltage plus base to emitter voltage. So this is the sum of VCB and VB. When we increase this VCE, the depletion width, so the reverse biasing at this junction increases, so depletion region width increases also. That's why base region, actual base region reduces, so the combination of electron and hole pair is less here. So most of the electrons from emitter region goes towards the collector region and collected by this collector region. That's why collector current, means IC, increases. By observing these curves, we can see easily here that dependency of IC is more on IB rather than VCE. So we can say CE transistor configuration amplifies the input current and gives a higher value of current at the output side. That's why this transistor configuration is used as an amplifier in active region. The current amplification factor of this transistor configuration is represented by beta. This is the current amplification factor of this configuration. It is IC upon IB, and it has higher value because IC is much greater than IB. Now we will discuss saturation region. Saturation region occurs when we decrease the value of VC. When this value of VC is almost equal to 0, the collector and base junction become forward bias. So in this case, in saturation region, collector base junction and also the base emitter junction both are forward bias. So if in this region we slightly increase the value of this VCE, there is a large increment in the current, and also the current in this region is independent of the value of IB. As there is large increment in IC by slightly increasing the value of VCE, this region is used as a switch when the switch is on. When the switch is in on condition, this region is used. Now we will discuss cutoff region. This occurs when IB equals to 0. This IB is equals to 0 when we will reduce this VBE, and when we reduce this VBE, this base and emitter junction becomes reversed bias. And because collector base junction is already reversed bias by this battery, so both the junction in this case are reversed bias. As in this case, main current IC is almost equals to 0. That's why this region is called cutoff region. We can explain this by total current equation of in case of common emitter configuration. The total current equation is IC equals to beta IB plus ICU. When we set the value of IB equals to 0, this term becomes 0. So the only current that flows in the circuit is ICU, that is collector to emitter current when base is open. This ICU is equals to beta plus 1 ICBO. So the current that flows in this case is IC equals to beta plus 1 ICBO equals to ICU. As we know, the value of beta is higher in case of common emitter configuration. So this leakage current in case of common emitter configuration is higher than common base configuration. As the value of IC in cutoff region is almost equals to 0 because it is just equal to leakage current. So as the leakage current is very less, so in this region the transistor is used as an switch in off condition. Now we will find the output resistance of this configuration. In this configuration, in common emitter configuration, the value of output resistance is high, and it is given by change in collector to emitter voltage upon change in output current, that is IC, at a constant value of base current IB. We can find the output resistance by using these curves, by taking any two point on any of these curves and drawing the perpendicular on both the axes and finding the change in VC and change in IC, we can find the output resistance. I hope you like the video. If you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe the channel. Thanks for watching the video.